It's a rainy day.
In port, no leakage, no leakage at all.
Hello and welcome to Taboretum channel. And you want to print something watertight? Well, it's feasible. Let me demonstrate. It's a container that I've designed. It contains some water. There's another one. There's a simple cylinder. And let's see if it works. You can see water being poured. And yeah, let's pour everything. Yeah, it's full. And you see, no leakage, no leakage at all. Let me, left hand, it will be tougher. Yeah, I've made it. Yeah, you can hear it. It's a real thing. With my left hand, I won't go that high. So that's what you can achieve. Now the question is how to get there and not do what I've done before, because what you can easily end up with is, here is the same shape, same design, same printer actually, same plastic, it's PLA, but different settings. And let's see what happens here. It's a rainy day, so you can definitely water your plants with it, but that's not necessarily the result you've been looking for. So how to have this rather than this? Let's see. My simple recipe is 1. Higher temperature, 2. Wider line, 3. Half the speed, you need to print slower, 4. Increase the flow rate to 120%, even 120 for the bottom part, for the bottom solid layers, and 5. Avoid retractions to avoid gaps in your print. And number 6, if you wish, stay low with your layer height. I'm looking forward to see your ideas for watertight prints. And thanks for watching and happy printing. If you're planning to 3D print watertight objects, you have 2 options. Either print them watertight or seal them afterwards in the post-processing. And today we'll talk about printing them already watertight. One day I plan to do a video on sealing them, but today let's concentrate on printing them already watertight. So if you want to print an object watertight, the aim is obvious. You don't want to have any gaps through which the water can go through, right? So this object is printed in a vase mode or spiral mode, where actually, just after printing the bottom, the whole print is one single line that is a spiral. It's only possible for simple shapes like this one, that every slice of it is a closed line, right? Because if you would have, let's say, 2 elements and you slice it, this would be 2 separate islands, and the printer cannot print them as an island, as a spiral. However, you can design things in a way that they are actually printable in the vase mode, which is super useful, because if you have the proper settings, the vase, the side of it, will be easily watertight. The only problematic part will be the bottom. The bottom part is usually number of lines in one direction and then the perpendicular set of lines, and again for all the layers, right? So what you end up with, here is the stopped print where you can see the layers and you can see what I've been talking about. If you look closely, you will notice that in this case, we ended up with a fork by fork type of print. So to what we want to do, first of all, we want to go slightly higher with the temperature. That's the number one. Because you want the plastic fully melted and you want a very tight bond between layers and between lines. So first thing, higher print temperature. So if your manufacturer says that the PLA is 185 to 210, go to 210 if it's not too stringy at that setting. So go rather to the high end of the temperature range. Temperature, number one. Second thing is extrusion width, right? So you want to extrude broader lines. If you think about that, if your nozzle is 0.4 millimeter and you're extruding 0.4 line and the height of the line is 0.2, you're basically extruding a shape like that. One on top of the other, and then they are touching each other as parallel lines, right? So if you extrude twice the width, the connection between the layers will be twice that wide, which means it will be twice as strong, right? So what I recommend, the second thing is to print double the width of your nozzle. And yes, it is doable. It's a matter of your, if your heater is capable of providing enough heat, but you can usually go 200% of your nozzle width. So in this case, in this case, it's a 0.4 nozzle printing at 0.8 mil. And this animal here is even more than that, because this is 0.6 nozzle printing 1.2 millimeter wall at once. So number two, the width, 200%. Number three now, if you change this parameter, number three is go slow. Because if you are at your sweet spot in terms of melting plastic with the 0.4 or 0.5 width of the line, and now you switch to double that, you probably need to go half of the usual speed. So high temperature, double the width, half of the speed. These are three basic things. And then you have a long list of other settings that you can play with. For example, when I was printing this animal, I was using a fresh install of Prusa slicer. And what I've noticed is that by default, for one of the printers that I've used, Prusa is setting up the extrusion multiplier at 0.95, which means it's under extruding by definition, which means it's super easy to get here a sieve instead of a solid bottom. So in your slicer, look for the parameter that is extrusion multiplier or flow rate or whatever is the name in your case, and make sure that it is at least one. Honestly, what I usually do for the bottom part, I go even as high as 120%. Because if you think about the parallel lines touching each other, you even want to over extrude and have actually a bump over there rather than under extrude and have a gap. Because if you have a gap and then another gap in the next layer, you will end up with a sieve, right? So the fourth option that you might want is to go for the bottom part with the extrusion multiplier or flow rate or whatever the name of it is at 110-120%, just for the bottom part. Because once you go for the vase mode, you can stick to 100% because it will be enough with the double the width. The fifth thing that you might consider is, what about your retractions, wipe moves, pressure advance, and other things like that? Because what you can easily happen, if you dialed all everything to make a beautiful print, it might mean that you are retracting a lot and some invisible gaps are printed. So if you look for a seam, you may end up to see that there is actually a gap. And even if you can't see it, the water might find it, right? So the best way is to actually either limit your retraction or actually disable it for this type of prints. So to summarize, one, higher end of temperature range of your filament. Two, double the line width. Three, limit the speed. Fourth, extrusion multiplier at 120 for the bottom and 100 for the rest of the spiral mode. And consider either stopping or limiting retraction. One more thing that is pretty obvious is your layer height. And I'd say for 0.4 millimeter, don't go above 0.15 millimeter layer height. For the 0.6 nozzle, I'm printing at 0.2. So that's it. And your prints are going to be watertight. And the material is not that important. So you can achieve that with PLA, with ABS, with PETG. So the sky's the limit. You can print colorful things. You can do whatever. Thanks for watching. Happy printing. See you soon. Bye-bye.